and welcome to Trap Talk TV.
This episode has been brought to you by the Lalit Suri Hospitality Group.
News this week. India allows free medical visa for Maldivians for a period of 90 days.
It's a path-breaking decision that now Maldivians can come to India not with visa on arrival, but visa-free like Nepal, like Bhutan. Visa-free for up to 90 days for medical tours.
European Tour Operators Association and UK Inbound sign an MOU with OTOAI, TAI and TAFI.
The key trade associations for inbound into the UK, ETOA, the European Tour Operators Association, and UK Inbound, are signing MOUs with their equivalents, so OTAI Outbound and TAI and TAFI from here, and we're supporting that and doing the ceremony on our stand. So it's about good bilateral relations and good reciprocal business.
Iqbal Mullah shares his thoughts on being the Thai president for the second term.
I will try my best to make sure our Indian entire travel industry should survive by getting at least 5% commission. But recently, so it's a good luck for us, the new year has given 2% commission by way of transaction fee from Indigo Airlines. Efforts we were putting from last several years in Bangalore for insisting that that weekly settlement is not part of our plan, and you are insisting on us that was wrong. So ultimately our request, Bangalore High Court has been recognized and they have put on an interim order that saying that weekly settlement should not be implemented. My unfinished agenda is there, like 100% I should get 5% minimum commission to the entire fraternity.
Kerala Tourism bags the UNWTO award. The Responsible Tourism Project at Kumarakom by Kerala Tourism has received the UNWTO Ulysses Award for Innovation in Public Policy and Governance at the International Tourism Trade Fair, FITUR, in Madrid, Spain. MakeMyTrip.com recently launched a revitalized B2B affiliate program.
It's a great experience for the agent because it is right there. It's a real-time inventory from our side, exposed through the technology tool that we would have given it to them. And they can also do real-time bookings on that. So the real push from our side is to not necessarily try and do it offline mode, in an offline mode where they can send us a query and we can respond to them. It is effectively to push the technology, give them a tool, and show them the inventory, and then accordingly they can book it online. So the whole push is through doing it technology-enabled rather than offline.
South African tourism looks forward to a good growth from the Indian market in 2014.
And it shows a huge investment from the South African side. They're looking at the Indian market, they're saying we're taking it really, really seriously. We need to come here, we need to come and meet with our suppliers. So I think overall we're in a really, really healthy position and we're looking for good growth for this year as well. We've seen a rise. If you look at our figures, you know, we're just under 10% up for the year. If you look at the figures up to the end of August, so it's a healthy year for us. You know, we think 2014, when things stabilize a little bit on the rupee dollar exchange rate, then the airfare should stabilize. So we're seeing a good growth for this year as well.
We actually started in Kolkata, so we'll be doing Delhi, we're doing Chennai, and then Mumbai. So every year we try and swap between the cities. Mumbai and Delhi are first tier cities, and then we swap through the secondary cities.
Andhra Pradesh Tourism to host the first ever Hyderabad Travel Mart from February 21st to the 23rd. The event will be held at Paryatak Bhavan and will become an annual affair. On the lines of the Kerala Travel Mart and the Gujarat Travel Mart, Andhra Pradesh Tourism for the first time will organize a B2B Travel Mart called the Hyderabad Travel Mart. Greek Tourism Organization hosts a workshop for the Indian travel trade.
India is still a pretty virgin territory. Not a lot of people know about Greece, so we're trying to change that, educate people about Greece, inform them, and get the travel agents and all the airlines and everybody on board this effort. Also, we have our own stand in OTM exhibitions in Mumbai from the 7th to the 9th of February. And in next trips, probably in May or June, we are planning to also visit some of the other cities like Kolkata, like Bangalore, Hyderabad, and make some sales visit to a lot of travel agents there too.
Goa is a theme state at the Surajkund Crafts Mela.
Last year, we had more than 8 lakh visitors, out of which more than 80,000 were foreign nationals.
People also to realize the convenience of using the technology and the net facilities that are available. And we have practically all the banks on board for the online booking for the first time.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition, but do look out for our next bulletin.
This episode has been brought to you by the Lalit Suri Hospitality Group.